last evening, some of the teens that go to South Windsor High School told me about the homecoming dance and how excited they were, which brought back memories of the eighth grade dance where all the girls were on this side of the gym, all the boys were on that side of the gym, and sister came on and said, come on, you're gonna have a good time, dance together. And the pastor would come around with a cigar and say, leave room for the Holy Spirit. There's different types of dance. There's the waltz, there's the mambo, the swing, the polka, break dancing, and disco. At St. Augustine School in Hartford, Sister Joan, the religion teacher, would teach all the children how to do the waltz. You'd be at the chalkboard, and all of a sudden you'd see about 60 children come by saying, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Why is it important that Catholics know how to dance? Because they know that the soul is the form of the body. To show with your body what you feel with your soul. Liturgy is intentional movement of the body. Show our Lord what we actually feel. We don't come into the sanctuary and wander around. We don't swing around the altar. We walk towards the altar. We walk around the altar knowing that it's sacred. We approach the pulpit. You do the same from your place in the pew. You sit, you stand, you kneel, you process, you recess. You demonstrate with your body what you feel with your soul. It's a body-soul composite. Protestants don't understand this. They think it's Catholic aerobics, jumping up and down all the time. We're not static. You kneel by your bedside. You bless yourself as you go out the door. You have holy water. You start a journey. You have a sacramental imagination that this secular thing is like this holy thing. And you make connections. But when you think about it, some people are better dancers than others. When my cousins, the Irish step dancers, would dance, the top of their body did not move, but the bottom was furious. Colombians all dance. They don't stop moving. I live with a Colombian. I live with the only Colombian that doesn't know how to dance. Father Carlos cannot move to save his life. So a friend of his comes over and I said, listen, teach him how to dance. And he said, impossible. I said, well, you know, teach him the tango. He says, Father, please. Tango is not a dance. It's an attitude. What is your attitude in worshiping God? Are you burdened? Are you grateful? Are you oblivious? Are you wondering if the Cubbies are going to clinch the series? Are you here? We can all wander during Mass and liturgy. Even when you're saying the Mass, you can wander, go way off after a couple of Masses. But the idea is to, first of all, and we could do it now, acknowledge the presence of God, and you're halfway there. You work with God. You're doing God's work, simply being present here. Now think, if you will, of some blessing for which you're grateful. Then ask the Lord, what's the most important thing for you now? What holds your attention? And then always, as Catholics, we look for forgiveness and healing, not as guilt-inducing, but rather as an occasion to learn about ourselves and those around us. Worship is a social event. We are not isolated here by ourselves, but with one another. Mass is really a framework on which to hang your emotions, your thoughts, your hopes, your dreams, your sorrows. You're able to examine your life and see the connection between others and God. We don't want to be like the Pharisee. Pharisee means separated ones, self-sufficient. You can't be self-sufficient in worship. You have a lector, you have a cantor, you have a deacon, you have a priest, you have servers. You have Eucharistic ministers, you have your fellow parishioners, you have friends, strangers, a couple of enemies here and there, but they're here. One of the best definitions I've ever heard of church is, here comes everybody. You have to ask yourself, as you move through life, and you're trying to pick out the right steps, as you're trying to kind of waltz your way through, or tango, you have to ask yourself, who's Lord of this dance? Who's Lord of your dance? Who is Lord?